All right, it is a brand new week. Hello, everybody, and welcome to Monday, July the 12th, 2021. The MLB draft started up last night, in which Gamecock signee second baseman Cooper Kinney was taken pretty early on in the competitive balance of round A with the 34th overall pick to the Tampa Bay Rays. So we're only losing one of the best players we signed, which is unfortunate, but if you're an 18-year-old given the opportunity to play for an MLB team for millions of dollars, what else are you going to do? And then today we lost right-handed pitcher Hunter Parks to the Cincinnati Reds in the 8th round, 240th pick. So, again, what are you going to do when you offer thousands of dollars? And then we lost some guys in our roster. Brett Carey, Brady Allen, and Thomas Farr all went in the 5th round. Was Carey going to the Angels, Allen going to the Marlins, and Farr going to the Reds. And then Jordan went to the Brewers in the 9th round. And then Andy Peters and Wes Clark went in the 10th round, with Peter going to the Angels and Clark going to the Brewers. And then we might also be losing Bosnick tomorrow in, round 11 for 20 somewhere. So we'll have to see if he signed. But I imagine, Carey, Allen, Farr, Jordan, Peters, and Clark are probably going to end up signing, which, sucks we're losing some of these guys, but you love to see, Gamecocks in the pros and them balling out in the big leagues. But we're going to be getting some good guys back. Eichner has hinted at coming back. Will Sanders isn't draft eligible until 2023, so he'll be back and, probably our Friday night guy. Now we're bringing in top talent, from this 2021 class, including Michael Braswell and Thad Ector. So, lock and reload. I mean, no one's better at doing that than Nick Saban, but,
All right, check left and right. Getting better every time we do it. Make sure your spacing stays good also. Don't crush together.
He turned to me as if to say, hurry boy, it's waiting there for you.
Alright, it is a brand new day. Hello everybody and welcome to Wednesday, July the 14th, 2021. We had a good flat summer section yesterday. Percussion, you know, putting together the opener, and it sounded pretty good for it being the week before band camp. And as we sit, I think 37 days away from, you know, the first Woodruff home game. You know, I like where we're at. I like where they're at. Show has high ceiling, and I feel like, you know, gonna be a good show for them once competition starts up in October. But yeah, MLB draft concluded yesterday, in which we lost a couple, you know, pitchers. Gamecock signee, right-handed pitcher Drew Baker, was drafted by the Phillies in the 11th round. I honestly feel like he's gonna sign. And then right-hander Danny Lloyd got drafted by the Orioles in the 14th round. I feel like he's going, at least that's what he indicated on social media. And then left-handed pitcher Julian Bosnick got drafted in the 16th round by the Giants. I feel like Bosnick's gonna stay though. He had, you know, a lot higher ceiling than the 16th round. But yeah, everyone drafted has until August the 1st to make up their minds about, you know, whether or not they want to come back to school or go to the league. So we'll have to see how these decisions shape up in the first few weeks. Although I feel like, you know, I feel like only Bodnik is staying. But we'll have to see. But yeah, we had 8 current Gamecock drafted, the third most of any college team. But yeah, UCLA had 10, Arkansas and Texas Tech had 9 each, and then USC and NC State had 8. Good numbers. And then added was 8, 6 of them were pitchers. Tied for the most with along with Arkansas. But the departures in the baseball program don't end there, as earlier today has been announced that the pitching coach Skylar Meade was named the head coach at Troy University. You know, he's been a good coach. One of the, you know, young rising stars. I mean, you saw what he did with the pitching staff. Yeah. Sucks that, you know, we're losing him, but, you know, just screams, you know, the quality of players and coaches that we have, that, you know, our assistant coaches can go be head coaches somewhere, and then, you know, we have several big league caliber players on our team. Then we also lost assistant coach and recruiting coordinator Trip Couch to Arizona. So, yeah, Kington's working to fill those spots. And there's a lot more other news, like, you know, along the football line, but I'm probably going to talk about that tomorrow. All right, the first climb up the tower as the new band director. They do. Doesn't look the cleanest. They do not look parallel, like, especially what, down to 50?
They're just, they don't start and end at the same spot.
That's yeah. But that does look like a football field.
Yep. Cool.
Alright, so I may have lied. It's not tomorrow. It's now Friday, July the 16th, 2021. Obviously, yesterday was footage of, you know, the painted band field since I went up to the high school and helped out Gilstrap. But yeah, we got some more football stuff to talk about. From Wednesday, Kevin Harris received the Blanchard Rogers Trophy presented by the South Carolina Football Hall of Fame, which he had the first Gamecock to receive. I've seen it referred to as South Carolina's Heisman, so, you know, congrats to Kevin Harris. He's going to be lighting up some more SEC defenses in 50 days. Yep. And I'll hopefully get the respect he deserves. And yeah, also on Wednesday, SEC Media Days details were revealed and announced, in which Shane Beamer will be speaking at 4 p.m., and he will be taking Nick Muse and J.J. Nigbare with him, so yep. A lot of people are kind of, I guess, surprised to not see Kevin Harris, you know, reinforce the image and the idea of, you know, SEC's leading rusher, best back in the conference, but never really had been, you know, media guy. It feels like it, you know, shows up, does his business. But yeah, gonna be nice to see Nick Muse. He's quite the character, and J.J. Nigbare, you know, he's definitely gonna be one of our best guys on defense, you know, potentially a first round draft pick if he goes in 2022. So yeah, looking forward to media days on Monday. Don't know if I'm gonna get to watch it live because I'll be at band camp, but I'll try to catch it later. All right, it is a brand new day. Hello everybody and welcome to Saturday, July the 17th, 2021. If things look and sound a little bit different, You're not crazy. There's a reason for it. I ended up picking up a GoPro today, which, you know, had a little bit of extra money lying around, so, you know. I feel like this can come in handy, hopefully, during, you know, the marching band season. I have a bunch of accessories also on the way, so, you know, hopefully we can get some good content going. But yeah, looking forward to testing this guy out, you know, starting on Monday. I don't know how often this is going to be used, because it is honestly a lot easier to pull out the phone and just shoot a video. But, you know, using this GoPro, honestly, like, kind of, you know, I've been thinking about it, like, over the summer, like, you know, if I actually managed to get a job. No update on that so far. Like, you know, I'd put aside some extra money for a GoPro, but, you know. I just had a little bit of extra money lying around for my birthday and stuff, so I decided, well, why not? Let's go ahead and, you know, bite the bullet and buy a GoPro. So, yeah. I got a GoPro Hero 7 model, so. Not the newest, but, you know, it'll do enough. So, yeah, looking forward to getting the opportunity to test this guy out during the season. Alright, it's the end of the week. Hello, everybody, and welcome to Sunday, July the 18th, 2021. Been a bit of a busy day, so I wanted to quickly discuss a few things that have happened throughout the week that I didn't touch on yet. For starters, on Tuesday, left-handed pitcher John Gilreath is back for another season with Gamecock Baseball, so you'll love to see it. You'll love to see it after, you know, he's done some good stuff for us this past season, especially later in the season, like against Tennessee, that Thursday night game, for instance. And then former Gamecocks outfielder Brady Allen signed with the Marlins, so congrats to him. Going to do some good things in the big leagues, and we'll surely miss him with Gamecock baseball. And then after Tripp Couch left to go to Arizona, Kingston hired Chad Calliott, a former assistant at Texas A&M, and from what I hear, this was a really good hire. So you love to see Kingston, you know, quickly filling holes with, you know, good guys. And then, you know, a few updates on the Carolina band front. On Tuesday, we got our new cymbals finally in, and they're sitting at the band hall right now, presumably. We got new 19-inch Sabian AAX cymbals, a practice pair and a performance pair, so great to hear. Because we've had the same cymbals for 7 years, so yeah, we need new cymbals. Yeah, and I got a Zoom call for Carolina Band here in 12 minutes, so I need to quickly get this vlog edited from this week. And, you know, Carolina Band recordings are going well. Today pregame was due. And in 2 weeks from today, the cadence is due. And I already got the cadence done this week as well, along with pregame. But yeah, a little bit of a content update since we're going into Bandcamp now, Bandcamp season. You know, we got 3 weeks of Woodruff Bandcamp, and then immediately after that, we get like a week and a half of Carolina Bandcamp. That can be fun. My plan for Woodruff Bandcamp is to keep it running as normal through camp. Just try to be, you know, real conservative with how much I actually shoot. Because these vlogs get long, I'm sure. And I retroactively took some of the highlights from the past 4 weeks and made them a summer sectional highlight video that just went out a few minutes ago. And then I'm gonna make a Bandcamp highlight video as well. Just up in the air whether I want to do that weekly or just once Bandcamp is over. So we'll have to see. But yeah, lots of content flowing today. But yeah, it's been a good last, you know, week. So now life gets crazy.
Did I just play?